Drinks, 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 drinks. Yeah, it's going. In this video, I'll do another review. It will be one of the most talented weightlifter in the all times. His name is Asin Zlatev. It's from Bulgaria, and in this video, I'll review his 225 kilogram clean and jerk from 82 and a half category. When I was switched my category from 77 to 85. Asin Zlatev was one of my favorite from that category, and in that time he was the category was 82 and a half. So in this video I will want to review one of the greatest split jerker of all time. I was like it very much, especially his split jerk. I was trying and I was study him his split jerk, and I was trying to implement that in my split jerk. I was not succeeded yet, but I still have time. So let's watch first time at 225 kilograms. It's a third attempt, 82 and a half category. The clean was powerful. And the split jerk, the barbell was flying there. Asin Zlatev was a very talented athlete. We'll start with his start position. His hips are very high in this position from start. I see that his toes are pointed out. The arms are very good. The torso also is very good in this position. From the ground in the first pull, it's pretty aggressive. It's not trying to control it, and it's using a lot of power from first pull as well. He's very strong. He has a very good strength, because if you notice, it's able to accelerate constantly after the barbell it's passing from the ground, and when it's reaching at second pull, it's still very explosive. So this when you are able to constantly accelerate, this mean that you are powerful and that your strength is good. So I like his first and second pull. If we go forward here, when barbell it's passing the knees, it's very close. Here in power position, it's flat footed. It's very good. The knees are in a good position. His arms, if you notice, are straight. This is very good. And he has a mid tight contact, because he's keeping his arms very straight in this position, and it's not shrugging at all his shoulder here in power position. This one, it's leading that he's doing the contact a bit lower, like at mid tight. This is happen also of the athletes that are using very good the quads in the second pull. Not too much frames on this video, but if we look closely, we see that he was not fully extended here. Because if you look closely, his knees are a bit bended, and this is happen of the athletes that are very powerful, and in order to have a smooth transition and to not have any pause between second pull and turnover, you don't need to fully extend the knees. Because if you fully extend the knees and you do like a very powerful and you fully extend, you have two options. One, you will do a deadlift, that it's very bad for a weightlifter. It's the bad thing that could happen in the competition. And it's like his confidence, it's going a lot down when it's happened this one and they do deadlift. The second thing that could happen, it's that it's a lot of pause between second pull and turnover, and it's seeing how the barbell it's remaining a bit freeze in the air. So when Asin here, it's not fully extend his knees, he's able to do this turnover and to switch his direction very fast and very smooth. I like this one. I like very much this approach. What a nice arm work where his elbows. I really like it. Here in the receiving, the barbell was crushing a bit on him, but this was happened because he was using a very aggressive and very powerful second pull. Barbell was having a lot of height, and because he was very fast when he was switching his direction, the barbell was going up and he was going very fast down, and what's happened that crash there. But this for a professional athlete like him, we can understand that in this day Asen was even able to clean more than 225, so probably he was able to clean here to 30 kilograms or something like that, based of the height that the barbell was having here with 225 kilograms. On the way up, he was going very well. He was maintaining very well the position. The torso was very good. He has also a very strong core because he was going up from the hole very easy. Here is the front rack. I like a lot his position. The chin is a bit tucked in here. He has the barbell on shoulders. The elbows are pointed out. It's very good, this one. And it's seeing not very good here that it's keeping the barbell in full hand or maybe slightly on the fingers. He has the knees a bit bended here in the front rack, and if you notice his stance, it's very narrow. He has his legs very close together. If we go forward, here are the dip. He has a nice dip. It's a pretty long dip here. Elbows are remaining very good in the same position. They are remaining also out. His chest is very good. His head position is very good. And it's going straight down with hips here on the dip. That it's very good. He has a very good balance because if you look at the break, it's not even noticeable. He's going down and up very fast. The drive is very good. It's using nice the legs here. The barbell is getting a lot of height here. I like that it's throwing the barbell overhead with his leg and his torso, and after that it's only catching the barbell overhead. His left elbow, it's seeing that was doing a small press out there. Probably at the last Olympic competition the jury was give him a no lift, huh? And I don't know, probably they was let him because was a world record or something like that. We will don't know this one. He has a very good footwork. Back foot it's touching very good, and the weight it's distributed very well. It's not seeing very good in this video because it's from front, but I was studying him and I was seeing him in more videos, and he has a very good split jerk, a very very good format split jerk. He's recovering nice with front foot first and after that with back foot. What it's happened here and why you need to recover with first foot, because when you are in the split jerk and when you are recover first time with the front foot, you maintain the weight here, the balance of the weight on you. If you do otherwise, and if you push with and you recover the barbell with the back foot first, you will push the barbell in front and probably you will miss it. This lift was a very amazing lift. All the time when I watching, I look him multiple times because it's a very good attempt here. Asen Zlatev was a very good clean and jerker, and even if in these days this is a very very amazing lift. He has also here, if we look from the training, I will post this video here. He has a video that it's I think before 88 Olympics, and in the they say that it's 230 kilograms here on this attempt, but it's not seeing very clearly. For sure he has 220 kilograms plus here. The clean was very good. The split jerk was very good like usual, and overall this lift was very easy and very controlled for 230 kilograms at 85 kilograms body weight. So this is an amazing lift, even it's from training. So thanks for watching at this video, and we'll see in the next one.